Okay, what do we know so far? We have the relative purchasing power parity formula. Expected spot exchange rate in 1 year equals today's spot exchange rate multiplied by 1 plus the difference between the foreign country and the US inflation rates. 2. Interest rate parity. 1 year forward rate equals today's spot exchange rate multiplied by 1 plus the difference between the foreign countries and the domestic risk-free rates. 3. Unbiased forward rates. 1 year forward rate equals expected spot exchange rate in 1 year. What you can first do is, because the 1 year forward rate and the expected spot exchange rate in 1 year are set equal to each other in formula number 3, then in formula number 2, instead of putting F1 on the left hand side, we can instead put expected spot exchange rate in 1 year on the left hand side. So if you combine formulas 2 and 3, it will give us the so-called uncovered interest parity. Expected spot exchange rate in 1 year equals today's spot exchange rate multiplied by 1 plus the difference between the foreign countries and the US risk-free rates. So this is the uncovered interest parity. Then we can take this uncovered interest rate parity, which, by the way, can also be applied to any year t in the future if you just add the power t to the term in the parentheses. If you combine it with formula number 1, then we get another new result. So if you compare formulas 1 and the uncovered interest parity, they should look pretty much identical except for what we add to 1 in the brackets. In the relative purchasing power parity formula, which is formula number 1, in the brackets we have 1 plus H, which is inflation rate in the foreign country, minus the inflation rate in the US. In the last new formula that we have just derived, the uncovered interest rate parity, in the brackets we instead have 1 plus the difference between the foreign and the domestic risk-free rates. So the difference in the inflation rates equals the difference in the risk-free rates. That statement must be true. So combining these two formulas, we have the difference in inflation rates, HFC minus HUS, equals the difference in the risk-free rates, RFC minus RUS. This last result can also be rearranged to put everything for the US on one side and everything for the foreign country on the other side. So for example, if we move RUS to the left-hand side, it changes the sign from negative to positive. If we move H foreign country from the left to the right, it changes the sign to negative from positive. And we then get RUS minus HUS equals R foreign country minus H foreign country. And this last formula has a name,